Today, I'm going to show you how you can add a PayPal payment button on your WordPress site. And this is a perfect setup if you don't really want a full-blown e-commerce site like WooCommerce or adding EDD to your website, but you're wanting to accept payments here and there. It's very super convenient, and I'll walk you through it step by step. So the easiest way that you can add the payment is by creating a form, adding the payment form with that. There are a lot of WordPress PayPal plugins out there, but if you want a lot of flexibility in building out the order form and customizing it and sending off emails to people depending on what is put in on the form, what kind of payment it is, then WPForms is your best option. You can get started as a contact form with their free version, the light form, but to do the PayPal payment button, then we recommend you getting the pro version or higher because that has the PayPal plan a part of it. So what you can do is go to wpforms.com. You'll set up an account. Once you do that, you'll want to head over to your account section, go to downloads to download the form. Once you're here, you'll also want to copy your license key. Now that we have everything downloaded, we can come back over to our WordPress dashboard so we can install WPForms. So from here, we want to go to plugins, add new. And instead of searching for the plugin, we want to actually upload, and we can do choose file. I have it down here, so I'm just going to left click drag it. If you don't have that, you can find it where you just downloaded it. Let's go ahead and install the plugin. Once it's installed, you can activate the plugin as well. Now it's active, it's asking you to activate your key. If you ever need to come back to work on it, let's go to WPForms over on the left. And from here, I'm going to go to settings so I can install my license key. We'll paste that in that we copied. Let's go ahead and verify. And you should get a green message saying everything is good to go. Great. Now we can set everything up. The next area we want to go to is, let's go to add-ons. So this is where we're going to add the PayPal payment add-on. What's cool about this as well is if you have any other integrations with payment services such as Stripe, Square, Authorize.net, and a few others, then you can find them in here as well. But because I'm showing you how to add PayPal, we're just going to stick with adding the PayPal standard add-on. Let's go ahead and install it, and WPForms will go out and install it and activate it so then we can use it. Great. Now we can come over to the left and let's go ahead and click add new. And what we want to do here is we want to go ahead and name it. And the cool thing is they have a ton of templates to choose from, so you don't have to create it from scratch. So the one we want to start with is the billing order form, because that's going to use a lot of the fields and notifications that we will already use. And you see right here, we have name, email, phone, address, the items that we're wanting to sell, the total amount, and comment or message. So we can go in and change that. If you click on any of these items, then over on the left, you see the area on the left where you can change it. If you want to give this a different label name, you can do that. If you want to change the type of email or the type of name, for a lot of times I just like to use simple for whatever reason. If we don't need the phone, we can just come over here and delete that. So you can go through and do all the adjustments that you want with this. It's a perfect way to drag and drop and make it however you need. The one area we probably want to do is available items. So what are we selling? Let's go ahead and name that something a little bit better for them. Now we have this available items, and it's a multi-item checklist, or, you know, where they can just pick whichever one that they want. If you're offering multiple items, then you can do that and you can change the name here, as well as the price. If you're only offering one item, then we can remove this and go back to fields, and we can scroll down, and maybe we're just doing one single item. So let's just put the single item here. What are we selling? What is the price? And then the total amount, because we don't have multiples, we can actually remove that since we're just doing a single. Great. This all looks good. And we actually don't need the address because it's all online. So it's really simple. So I think the form is good. It's exactly what we want. Now we want to come over to payments so we can set up the PayPal standard. Now you see these are all the others that we could integrate as well. But like I said, we're just doing PayPal standard. So let's just go ahead and enable this. And you need to give it the email of your business for PayPal that you accept PayPal. So this is your PayPal email address. If you're going through and practicing and doing things like that, you can turn on Sandbox so you can test it before you're actually charging. And you can also say if it's products and services or donation. So we have that right. You want to add your cancellation URL or cancel URL. You should get that through your payment. There's some documentation that you can look at as well. So this is where you would send them. If you click on this, this is where you will send them if they don't complete the checkout. Shipping, we're not going to ask for an address because we don't need to. And then if you wanted to enable conditional logic, so this is if we have other fields, you could process or don't process depending on a field. That's a little bit more advanced for this, but you can do that, which is cool. So for all this, we want to click save just to save our settings so far. Now, one more section that we want to make sure that we're doing is let's go to settings because we want to make sure our notifications are set up properly. So under notifications, this is the email that will go through and it gets sent to admin email of the website. So if that's still your email address, then perfect. If not, you'll want to go in and change that. You can put in your actual email right here and you can change the subject line. What I like about this is I'm actually going to change this because if I just kept it like this, it would, and I got all these emails, it would all be the same and there's nothing to change it. So I'd get a little lost. So you can do something like show smart tags and you can add their name or their email address. So we'll add the name of whenever they put their name in there. So we'll know the different emails that are coming through and from, you can change that. You also notice that there is an indicator here that's saying that it might not go through properly just because of some technical details of how WordPress sets up. We have a whole video on how to set up WP Mail SMTP, and that just makes sure that you're getting these emails and that anybody who's purchasing are getting the emails. So you'll want to go through that. I'll have a link in the description below on how to set up WP Mail SMTP. But for this, we'll just show you how all of this is working. And then scrolling down just a little bit more, you could also do conditional logic. This is perfect, again, if say you have accounting or maybe you have different sales departments, you could do a conditional logic for one of the fields. We don't have many more fields here. So like if it's in one department, one email will get it. If it's a different department, a different email will get it. We're not going to do conditional logic for this, but that's another really cool thing. But what you can also do is enable if the PayPal has gone through, if the standard completed payment, so you only will get an email once it actually completes and then you'll see that. So you want to decide on whether you want to do that or not. I'm going to leave that off because I'd like to get them. That way, if something doesn't go through, at least I can reach out to them and say, hey, what can I do to help you? But we have all of our notifications set up. Then a final thing we want to do is confirmation. So when they do send the information, we want them to have some kind of confirmation on the page. And what's cool about this is you could redirect them to a particular URL, maybe a thank you page on what to expect next, or you can show a particular page. You can even just say, hey, thanks for your order, which is, we're just going to keep it simple like that, but it's very cool that you can see that here. And then we're going to leave this checked to automatically scroll to the confirmation so that they don't miss it if they're further down on the page than when this shows up. So all of this is cool. Let's go ahead and click save. And now we need to add it to our website. So we can come up here and click embed. And it's going to say, do you have an existing page that you want this to go on? Maybe a thank you page or an order page, or do you want to create that? And since we haven't created one yet, let's go ahead and click create new page. We're going to name it. I called it consultation is what they're paying for. So let's go ahead and create consultation. Let's go. And then it will actually create that page and it takes us here and it drops that in. So very cool. So we can go in here and we can create a little bit more around the page if we want to make it a little bit more enticing for somebody to purchase a consultation with us. For this, I think it's fine. So we can go ahead and click publish and then we can see the page. And now this is ready for us. Now, when somebody goes through and submits this, it'll go to PayPal and take their money for you. So quick setup for you to start getting money. Now, if you want to make sure that you're getting the emails and that the users are getting the emails, watch this video next as we walk you through step-by-step on how to make sure that your website is using WP Mail SMTP to take care of all the technical aspects of sending and receiving emails from your WordPress website. And I'll see you over there.